It's such a pleasure to be here at the first annual gathering of the Jokalos. I didn't even know it was happening, to be honest with you. It's a strange thing. I live on this boat. So it happens. You see, since the ads ended and I don't do that anymore, I now live kind of the melancholy and solitary life of a deranged millionaire. So I've lived on this cruise ship since April. I have the Dutch Master's Suite. It's a four-story suite with all the cherry tipperillos you can smoke. And it has its own canal, like Amsterdam, and hashish brownies in it. You are not welcome to visit, so thank you. And I keep busy, you know, I keep busy. I am the one, by the way, making all the towel sculptures in your room. Even the pornographic ones, John? Yes. Especially the pornographic ones. You may say, well, that's a lot of work. How could you possibly do that? How do you do that and keep busy that way? And I said, I do it at night while you're sleeping in your room. So if you see someone folding a towel in your room and then staring at you, it's probably me. It's nice. So I know a lot about this ship because I live here, and if you have any questions about it, I can tell you all about living on the ship and what life on the sea is like. This is a, you know, this is Holland American Lines MS Eurodam, which is a Mark 89 class Vista Mega Corsair. The keel was laid down in Italy in 2007, and it is currently levitating above the earth. On a soft, thick bed of water known as the Caribbean Sea, or as you probably pronounce it, the Caribbean Sea. Please stay away from the sea. It is dangerous to you. You cannot breathe in it, and there are things living in it, mostly fish, though other things too. The fish in the Caribbean Sea include the grouper, which is a trendy fish. The French grunt and the French chub and the double French chub and the parrot fish and the monkey head fish, also known as the Fiji mermaid, then the disturbing human head fish, closely related to the creepy smile fish, conjoined twin fish, the Kielekampf. Am I not pronouncing it correctly? Kielekampf? All here is Kielekampf? I'm going to say Kielekampf. You get out. The fish that tastes like shit fish?
That's the
Loup de Mer, the Loup de Mer. You probably know it from menus as the Werewolf of the Sea. And the Land's Bass.
I thought he tasted like shit.
That one was
only
a joke. Land's Bass is actually a very famous gay astronaut.
Unfortunately so.
You may be concerned. Are there sea serpents? And the answer is yes, obviously. Sailors require sea serpents to show them where the map ends. Unfortunately, it is unlikely that we'll see any sea serpents this trip because we are not going to get anywhere near the giant waterfall at the end of the world, which really angers me. So a word to the wise. The officers of the Eurodam are mostly Dutch, so don't bother bribing them. They will just laugh at you in Dutch and throw your bars of gold over into the ocean, and they won't take you to the waterfall at the end of the world, even though you can see it right there. However, the rest of the staff is delightful. And while tips are not required on the trip, I have found that a few well-placed nuggets of gold will get you a seat at the captain's table. And if you go to the kitchen and give them a few more nuggets of gold, they'll serve you only the freshest whole human head fish. And if you get one whose human head looks like the captain's head and eat it in front of him, it unnerves him. And if we all do it together on Thursday night, I think you will go insane, and then I will be the captain. The point I'm trying to make is, please stay away from the water. You will see among your fellow more experienced cruisers that it is better not even to look at the water the entire time you're on the boat. One of the great things about this ship is its amazing collection of fine wines. As some of you know, I host a red wine tasting in the Culinary Arts Center every morning at 7 a.m. We have a great time together. Oh, just talking about wine and how terrific it is, and sometimes not talking and just staring at each other. And sometimes we don't even turn the lights on. It's fantastic. Now, it may surprise you because indeed for many years I was pretty open about my ignorance about non-wine alcohols. In fact, David, are you here? Where's David Reese with my non-wine alcohol? Thank you. We're not supposed to have glass on stage, so I'll be very careful. As you've seen with my previous treatment of liquids on stage, I'll be very careful indeed, especially after I drink this. It's true that for many years I didn't know a lot about wine, and red wine in particular. I was intimidated by it. I thought that it was too sophisticated and complex, and something that only, you know, scholars and annoying dads and assholes could enjoy. But it turns out that's not true, for while red wine is very noble, it is also very humble. It is the simplest recipe in the world and one of the oldest recipes in the world to make wine, requiring only grapes, yeast, human feet, and time, plus an enormous amount of pharmaceutical pseudoephedrine and beakers and Bunsen burners. So, you know, if you are going to make a red wine lab, also I would recommend that you get some guns and some extremely violent dogs, because your competitors will come after you and try to steal all of your wine and then cut off your feet so that you can no longer make wine and perhaps bleed to death. And this is how the peasants of Europe have made wine ever since 6000 BC in quaint mobile red wine labs with thatched roofs. It's still a loot capture today. In Europe, red wine remains a part of daily life. You know, while we in the U.S. have demonized alcohol, we've had an ambivalent relationship with alcohol, unless we were on this boat. Most Europeans are always drunk and will frequently enjoy a glass of red wine even in the middle of one of their many naps. In France, children do not hide their drinking. They join their parents at the dinner table and are served red wine at the table with their parents because it is believed that it will make the children more sexy. So how can you learn to enjoy red wine just like the sexy French children? It's easy. Of all the varieties of wine, white wine, red wine, box wine, prison wine, and sparkling wine, which is commonly called champagne, but is technically called French Thunderbird. The best kind of wine is red wine. Yes. Named for its color, red wine. I like that one. I don't know why that's funny. Named for its color, red wine has the most healthful tannins and antioxidants, and that is why the baby boomers love it. For doctors agree, if you drink red wine, you will become immortal, and you will start to look like Francis Ford Coppola, and you will learn to tell long, pointless stories at the dinner table that go nowhere because you love the sound of your own voice. To your health, asshole dad. To your health. Boy. Red wine also offers the greatest depth of flavor, ranging from the bright berry, ozone, and burnt hair notes of a jammy Cabernet Beausoleil to the wine of the luxuriously pungent Argentine Velociraptor grape. with a tint of bitter chocolate and chewed up aluminum foil and fried crickets. Experts know that these wines have the viscosity of Marmite and spit. And experts also know to not even pour them, just simply rub them on your bare chest like a poultice. Some famous people who enjoy drinking red wine include Val Kilmer.
The end.
Finally, a note on choosing wine. You may think that it's enough just to read Val Kilmer's red wine blog and drink what he drinks. And for the most part, you do fine following his advice. But let me warn you that Val Kilmer sometimes gets confused and drinks Thousand Island dressing. So it's important to develop your own palate. But go to a reputable wine shop and just start exploring. You know, just look at the labels. Does the label have a kangaroo on it? It's probably a good wine. Does the label have, like, a quirky hand-drawn picture of the vineyard owner's dog on it? And is the wine named for that crazy old smelly dog, like crazy smelly dog wine? It's probably pretty good. Oh, but make sure the font on the label is cool. No cursive, no serifs, understand? And remember, don't buy anything that has a landscape on it. If you buy a wine with a landscape on the label, that means you are not intelligent. One great way to learn about wine, and you can take advantage of this when we come into port, is to take a tour of the vineyards of Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Oh, as you drink and drive and drink and drive from vineyard to vineyard, don't be afraid to ask questions. Ask the salesperson, is this a white wine? And if the salesperson says yes, then throw it on the ground. Ask the salesperson, is this a red wine? If the salesperson says yes, good. Drink as much as you can, fast. And then fall asleep in a field. You may ask, what if the wine is colored red with blood? That is a rosé wine. And that is good if you are a Spanish vampire. And that is all you need to know about wine.
In peril on the sea.